We're in the Palazzo Pubblico, or Town Hall, in Siena.
Remember that Siena was a city-state. It was its own country. It had its own government. We think about Italy as a unified country, but back in the 14th century, Italy was divided into city-states, and Siena was one, and it was a very proud republic.
And it was very wealthy through manufacturing and banking, primarily. In fact, well into the 14th century, the city was known as the bankers to the papacy. And in addition, the city gained a tremendous amount of wealth because it was on the road between France and Rome. And so anybody who was going on a pilgrimage would stop here, and of course the city would enjoy the benefits of that tourist trade. There were two main centers of power in the commune that was Siena, and that was the church, and that's exemplified by the Duomo at the top of the hill, and then down here, just at the bottom of the field, or what is known as the campo, sits the Palazzo Pubblico. And in one of the main meeting rooms where the rulers of the city, the Nine, met, we have an extraordinary series of frescoes by Ambrogio Lorenzetti.
And those are meant to remind the rulers of the city their responsibilities to be good and just.
And the dangers of not...
And an allegory means figures that stand in for ideas. We might want to note first that the door where the Nine would enter is right beneath the personification of justice, who sits looking up to another figure who personifies wisdom. And justice is doing just that. She's meeting out justice. In her hands, she's got scales with an angel on either side. And on her left, she meets out justice in the form of a reward, and on the right, as punishment.
And that is quite the punishment. An angel in the right scale is actually cutting the head off somebody who clearly was guilty.
But it's important that she looks up to wisdom.
Now, you'll notice that there's a small cord that goes from each of those scales down to a seated figure who has in her lap a plane. That is the kind of tool that a carpenter would use to smooth rough spots, or in this case, to create a certain degree of equality among the different levels of society. That plane has the words concord written on it, and it's just at about that point that those two cords from the angels in the scales come together and are handed to the figure in a blue robe. That cord then winds its way through all of the figures who are standing at the bottom, figures that are meant to represent the people of Siena, and they are all held in line, held in check by these cords that come from justice herself. If we move to the head of that line, we can see the cord rises and is held by the largest figure, and that is the personification of the good commune.
And an allegory, this figure is surrounded by various virtues.
On the left, you can see peace, and in fact, the hall in which we stand is called the Hall of Peace, named after her.
She's reclining. She's relaxed. It's almost as if everything else is working, if all of these other figures, justice, concord, fortitude, prudence, if they're all working, there's peace. And there's nothing much for her to do.
She relaxes, by the way, on a cushion. But if you look under the cushion, you can see black forms. That is meant to be armor. And originally, it would have been silver, but it's oxidized over time. So she's taken off her armor, and she can now relax. So as you said, if all of these allegorical figures are doing their job, then the city is at peace and prosperity can reign. And there is a very clear image of that in the fresco on the right. And this is the effects of good government in the city and in the country.
This figure, and we see the walls of the city of Siena.
Now, we should caution that probably the first few feet on the left are a restoration and are not by Ambrogio. This is one of the most ambitious, perhaps the largest landscape and cityscape, certainly, that existed in the medieval. I can't even think of a Renaissance painting that is more ambitious than this.
Well, and its subject is secular. It's not a biblical. This looks like the landscape around Siena. There's a real sense of the observation of the natural world, which is so unusual and new for this time.
And if you look carefully, you can see some figures on horseback that are just leaving the city. These are obviously wealthy aristocracy. In fact, one holds a falcon. They're going out hunting. As you go a little further, you can see a peasant who is walking into the city with a pig, clearly bringing that pig to market. There are donkeys that are bringing grain from the fields. In the distance, there is a kind of combination of both the season of spring and the season of summer. We see both the sowing of the fields and harvesting going on. So when you're looking at the allegory of good government, to your right is the effects of good government in the country and the city. But opposite that is bad government. The main figure that is in opposition to justice, if you look carefully, looks just like a devil with horns, fangs. But in back of that male figure is the words tyranny. And so we have justice and tyranny who are in opposition. Tyranny is surrounded not by virtues, but by vices. And you can see, for instance, avarice, vainglory. Down below is a bound figure. And here we see, sadly, justice, who is no longer ruling the city. And this fresco is in very poor condition, but we can just make out the walls have holes, the windows have been broken, and there's a sense of fear among the citizenry.
In fact, I see below a woman being carried off by two men in a very menacing scene, and below them a fallen, wounded figure.
To the left of the city, we see fields, but these fields have been burned. We can see the flames of houses on fire, and it is a So this room becomes a very clear message, both a promise and a threat to the government.
We see Simone Martini's Maestà of the Virgin based on Duccio's Maestà, which is in the cathedral.
So the Virgin Mary, reigning queen of Siena, taking her place beside the allegorical symbol of justice, both seated, both enthroned.
And this idea that the Virgin favors Siena, and in favoring Siena has given it a republic that the government of Siena must now protect. We see Simone
And in one of the main meeting rooms where the rulers of the city, the nine, met.
And an allegory means figures that stand in for ideas.